anytime she come around, something is about to go down. Listen to the siren sound. Wake up right now.
Thank you for watching Ebony Ladies in the DR. I'm your host, Bridget. Bienvenidos a mi canal. Gracias por ver. Happy New Year, everybody. It is 2022. It seemed like good years fly by. I say it every year. Good years fly by. It went so fast. So shout out to everybody that made it another year, right? Because it was a tough year for some people. But 2022, Ebony Ladies in the DR, we're going to be bringing a lot more episodes, a lot more information. I'm going to revisit some episodes because a lot has changed in almost the 3 years that I've been here in Punta Cana. So I'm going to be going out, showing you more restaurants, more little shopping areas. We have quite a few new businesses that have popped up. They are incredible. So a lot of good things going on here in the DR. I'm excited. This year, I'm still going to be doing my episodes as well as trying to build my bridal business, which is growing. So guys, don't forget to share all of my episodes and share and subscribe to my channel. Let people know that there's a bridal shop here in Punta Cana. I really do appreciate it. And this Ebony Lady can help you with your sell home purchases here in the DR. Y'all know I'm doing real estate. I love it. You listen, guys, my name is Bridget. Everybody likes to call me Ebony. I know when you see me on the street, that's the first thing that comes to your mind. No problem, but it is Bridget. So this Ebony Lady in the DR, thank you all for subscribing to the channel. I appreciate it as always. So Devlin and I, team boy behind the camera, gonna be doing a lot of good things, like the next episode that's coming up right after I finish this. Roll into the next episode, keep watching, because everybody wants to know, how did you get all of your beautiful furniture? Furniture is so expensive in Punta Cana. Yes, it is, but I am becoming an expert of finding good deals. So if you need me to shop for you, that's on my list of things and services that I do now. But we ship to containers. So everybody's asking me the whole process about shipping a container. Following this, in 2 seconds, you're gonna get all about how to ship a container. If you still have questions, put them in the comment section. I'm happy to answer them. If I have to do a follow-up that I missed that much stuff, I will gladly do a follow-up. So guys, don't forget, hit the subscribe button. I don't know how to do the notification thing. Hit the notification thing and then you'll get my episodes. I guess that's how that works. So y'all see, I'm still kind of an amateur YouTuber, but I'm working on it. But hit the subscribe, like, and share button, and I will see you every Thursday, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I'm so excited, and be sure to follow me on my other platforms. I'm all over social media. So I have Instagram, I have Facebook. You can follow me on all of those, and you can message me through any of those channels. I look forward to hearing from you. It's going to be some fabulous episodes this year, 2022, because my subscribers have voiced their opinion that they want to be on here. So you're going to be meeting a lot of frequent visitors to the DR that are my subscribers and that are part-time expats. So I'm looking forward to it. You guys should too. And look, you might be sitting there watching this episode and then what? Next time you're on an episode, because that's how it goes, right? But Ebony Ladies in the DR, enjoy the episode all about shipping a container. Thank you for watching Ebony Ladies in the DR. I'm your host, Bridget. Bienvenidos a mi canal. Gracias por mirar. So today's episode, everybody, is about the container. Everybody wants to know how to ship, the best way to ship if you're bringing a lot of stuff. So if you watch past episodes, especially the anniversary episode, you all know that we shipped a 20-foot container. We came from Houston, Texas to Punta Cana, and one of the restrictions was you had to be in the country when your container came in. So that's how we decided when we were going to ship our container. So I'm going to give y'all a lot of information as always today, and it might be a little bit out of order, but I'm going to do my best to kind of keep it in line. Okay, so when shipping our container, you know me, I'm all about the budget. So I did a lot of price comparison. There are a lot of container shippers out there, especially if you're in a port city. Houston is a port city. We have the Port of Houston. So made it a little bit easier by being in a port city. So what I did, and when I finally found our company, and I'm going to try to find the information so that I can put it down in the comment section. But when I found our company, I asked a million questions because the website was kind of vague. It was just like, we'll ship your things, we'll get them there. But it didn't give you all the details you needed to know. So it was really important for me to have all that information. So as always, I did my homework and I did everything I needed to do. Okay, so shipping a container, it depends on the time of the year. So because we were shipping from Houston to Dominican Republic, and you know when high season is, November through February, like right now we're in high season. If I had shipped the container in the summer months, like May, June, July, August, it was really close to almost $2,000 price difference. Final price for ours was just over $6,000. I know I'm going skip to the end, come back to the middle, but you know how I do. So it was like $6,000, and then we got $1,800 back when the container was returned. We did a 20-foot container. In our container, you know, I had everything. We had this chaise lounge, all of our iron patio furniture, 3 bikes, a king bed, 2 full beds, our sofa is like 8-9 feet long, a huge sofa, our dining room set, you name it. We had tons of stuff. I had oversized concrete flower pots. So the container was stuffed to the rim. And the kitchen sink. You know, when we were loading up, somebody was like, damn, you got everything. But the kitchen sink, I was like, ah, wait a minute. If you know me, I do have a kitchen sink because I like a double sink. And so, and when we bought the house, when we came here, it only had a single sink, and not my style. Okay, so when I found the container company, the questions that I wanted to ask are like, how long is it going to take to get there? What's the procedure? You know, what's the customs information? Are you going to handle all of this for me? So what you want is a full service broker from whatever city you're going to start from to the city, your final destination. Full service broker means they are going to handle it all the way through. Now, they're going to handle it all the way through, but when it got to Dominican Republic, it went to a partner. It went to one of their partners here in this country. Still same broker. I was still able to call him and get information, but he was no longer my agent per se, but he still helped me out. Okay, so with shipping a container, it is very tedious, but the only thing that you are going to be responsible for, and they're not going to tell you this, but you should have an inventory list in each box. Not just one inventory list for the bill of lading to give to the to send to your broker. You should put a copy of your inventory list in each box. Now, if you read the Facebook postings of the people who say that they shipped a container and all of their electronics were stolen, all of their tools were stolen. Now, if you know my husband's a handyman, so we had a lot of handheld tools. His big tools we sold in Houston, we didn't bring. His handheld tools he brought, things that we're able to use, our drills, our, you know, power circular saw, not the big one, but the medium size, stuff like that. And then we had 3 TVs, a huge 55-inch TV, and I think the other ones are like 50 or 45, something like that. Nothing missing. All of our tools, all of our electronics, all of that stuff intact. The only thing that was not even missing was broken was one glass, and I think it was probably due to my packing because it was when one of the first boxes when I started. So it's very important that you have an inventory list in each box, and don't tape your boxes until you have packed and done everything. Okay, so then you can add your inventory lists to the box, and then you want to number your boxes in sequence. 1 of 55, 2 of 55, 3 of 55. That's what I did, and I had a lot of boxes, and I was able to, as I broke down my boxes once they arrived here in Punta Cana, I was able to put those boxes in order to say, okay, I got all 55 of my boxes plus all of my inventory. All right. So in Houston, what happened is we had to, because our house sold super fast, we had to move everything from our house to a storage facility. And so we were going back and forth to the storage facility and packing. So when I arranged it with the broker, there was the 18-wheeler would bring our container that morning. So with the broker that we had, I think we had 4 hours. No, I don't think it was that long. I have to confer with Devlin on that. It was less than that. To load our whole truck. So we hired a couple of my friends and they helped us. Okay, pardon me. How long did we have to load the truck in Houston?
We had 2 hours
to load the truck and only 1 hour, yeah. 1 hour in Punta Cana to unload the truck. So you know us, use our muscle, manpower. So we had 2 people helping us. We loaded the truck in Houston. The container came, and then that once everything was loaded, they took it away. They put a seal on it. We took a picture of our seal. They gave us our bill of lading, all of our information. It then went to the port. Okay, I don't know how long the process was at the port. It was a few days, and then it left the port of Houston and went to Miami. So it sat in Miami, I know, 4 or 5 days, because I was tracking it. And then once it cleared and did everything that they had to do in Miami, went to Santo Domingo. Santo Domingo, as we all know, is the capital of everything Dominican Republic, baby. So it had to go to Santo Domingo. When it got to Santo Domingo, that's when my broker that I was telling you about, that's when the broker information switched. But I still called my same person, but I, in turn, had an additional person that I could speak with and deal with. Okay, so with customs, they opened every single box. They went through every single thing that we had. And again, nothing was missing. We had one broken glass. That was it, you know, but everything was there. But I had my inventory sheet, because you're going to put a copy in each one of your boxes. You're going to give a copy. You have to fax it to your agent when you make your payment, your initial payment to get it started. There's a deposit, right? You're going to send your papers there, and then you're going to keep a copy, of course, for yourself. All of your documentation you're going to need to have, because when it gets to the end in Santo Domingo, it's going to be time to present those documents. Now, once your container is in the country, you will have to go to Santo Domingo, sign paperwork. We had to go twice. You went first time. No, I take that back. You go when your customs and everything is cleared. And it took almost 2 weeks for them to clear all of our items, all of our goods through customs. So now this is including the customs charges, the luxury taxes, all that kind of stuff. Now, I had some designer bags, ladies. Let me tell you something. If you have a collection of designer bags like Louis Vuitton, Gucci, Prada, Hermes, if you're that kind of a baller, then you want to put those in your luggage and bring them on the plane. I made a mistake of packing my Louis Vuitton bags that I did keep, because I sold a lot of them before I got here. Oh, Dominican Republic know all about the Louis Vuitton, baby, because they put some luxury taxes on that box, right? So, but my whole total of all of my taxes and everything with the container that we had to pay was just over the $6,000. Now, there's a lot of misinformation that people think once you get residency, oh, it's going to be free customs. They're not going to charge you the taxes. Whew, that is absolutely incorrect. You are going to get a small break on your taxes, your sus impuestos, no gratis. It is not going to be free. It is not going to waive that custom tax. It is just going to give you a little break for having residency.
That's it. I did not have residency when we moved here. When we shipped our container, we got here January 13th. Our container got here, I think, the day before my husband's birthday. It was cleared. It was like February the 2nd or 3rd. It was before his birthday. And we didn't get residency to a few months on down the line because, you know, you had to turn in all of your paperwork. If you watched Ebony Ladies in the DR, I already did that residency episode. If you need to go back, once you finish this video, keep on watching. Just go ahead and go back and watch the residency video. Okay, so residency does give you some perks, but not the perk that you're hoping for. It is not going to take away all of that tax. You're still going to have to pay some of the taxes. All right, what should I have waited, or could I have waited, or do I wish I have waited? Well, of course, we all want to save money, but it just didn't work out that way for us because we were ready to move. We were here. We were ready. Our container was here. So we had to pay. But if you're a planner, budget that amount in. So then if it comes in a lot less because you got that residency status already and they gave you the discount, then look at there. Your Dominican Republic savings is off to a wonderful start because you've saved some money. But if not, budget it. I planned ahead. I knew that my price was going to be right at the $7,000 mark. I saved for it. So I wasn't disappointed. I wasn't surprised. It was all good, right? Okay, perfect. Okay, now once your container is clear, you do have to present yourself in public in Santo Domingo at the Customs and Border Patrol. You're going to sign some documents, not a lot. We were there maybe 30 to 45 minutes, if that. And you go, you sign all your documents, and then you make your payment. Okay, people, it has to be in cash. So that threw me because I was really ready for the wire. And we have brought, you know, brought so much money cash with us to live on for, you know, like 6-7 months. Before we opened our bank account here. But oh no, not the Dominican Republic, no wires. For the container customs, it had to be cash. So we had to go in our little savings that we had here in our safe and pay that in cash. So that's something you want to definitely be aware of. And I don't know if it's something that we could have worked out ahead of time with the broker to know that, to wire it to the broker and then he took care of it. But that's just live and learn. That's how I found out. So that was the situation. So we went to San Domingo, paid everything in cash, got all of our receipts, got all of our customs clearance. Boy, was it a happy day. Okay, so then we arranged the truck driver. So the truck driver, they had to find a truck driver that was coming to Punta Cana that week. Because I'm like, hey, I can't wait no more. It's time to get my couch. I need my bed. Okay, so we found a truck driver, and he brought our stuff like 2 days later. So that ended up being like February the 3rd, the day before my husband's birthday. So, you know, Santo Domingo, Punta Cana, a couple of hours. So I'm like anxiously waiting in the driveway for him to come, and he couldn't find our house, right? Once he got inside Cocotá. So I went walking because I hadn't got my bike yet, and then, of course, we didn't have a car. So I went walking, and I saw that I went to the back gate where he was and got in the 18-wheeler with him and came around the perimeter to our house. Now, when you get to your house, we are very budget-friendly. So we pay for self-unloading, like we self-load it. Those are all the extra fees, but you only get this 1 hour. 1 hour to unload a 20-foot container. Muscles at work again. So it was myself, my husband Davlin, our friend Reggie, and who else? The security guard for Cocotá was on the perimeter, and the truck driver. Everybody helped us. It was seamless. We did it nonstop. Didn't take a break for lunch or for water. Nothing. We got everything off the truck into our driveway. You know, we have a really big driveway, and got it done. The container went back. We signed some documents. And I say about not even a week later, they called us from customs to say that they had money for us. Money for me? What? Oh my God, this was something I didn't even anticipate, did not know. We went down there and it was the check for $1,800. It was our refund for the container. So people make it seem like, you know, doing these things are like a nightmare, and this is gonna happen, that's gonna happen. I literally just gave you from A to Z on shipping a container, and however minutes long this video is, it's not a hard process. The hardest part is deciding what to bring and what to leave. But you gotta pack up everything. You gotta wrap everything. If you're not a good packer, if you don't want to take the time to do it, put that in your budget. Hire professional packers to wrap up all your things that you really want to bring here. And you know, people ask us all the time, was it worth it to get a container? Now, I just told y'all how much it was, right? Just over $6,000, and we got $1,800 of that back. So now we're doing real estate, and so we're helping customers furnish their home. Yes, absolutely worth it to bring all of my stuff that I brought from the United States, because the quality of furniture that you're looking for and that you're going to want is going to be dining room sets, $3,000-$4,000, beautiful ones, couches that we pay, you know, like $700-$800 for in the U.S. and these are really good couches, or $2,000 upward. You know, that's our starting, that's our prices, that's our price range in the U.S. for a nice comfortable sofa. My sofa is huge, it's over $2,000 sofa, but of course I didn't pay that much, I found a deal. But here in Punta Cana, furniture, guys, beautiful quality furniture is very expensive. Towels, expensive. Sheets, expensive. You know, those kind of things that you really want in your home. So for me, and bikes, let me say that bikes are super expensive here, so we brought all of our bikes with us. So for us the container was worth it. For some people it may not be worth it, but this video is for the people that are asking me a million questions about shipping a container, and you know I'm all for it. I love to answer questions, I love to share my first-hand experience. I told y'all, quit listening to these people giving you advice on shipping a container that has not shipped a container. Okay, and I'm gonna try to find the pictures, because look, it's almost 3 years in January that we did this. So I'm gonna try to find the pictures so Davlin can shoot a couple of pictures of our container when it left the storage unit in Houston, and when it drove off down the street in Houston, and when we were unloading and loading at our storage facility in Houston and unloading here at our new home in Punta Cana. Y'all, that sun is on fire today. As always, I love Punta Cana. Y'all know I love the sunshine. But those are the facts about shipping a container. Is so worth it. It really is. If you have any more questions, don't hesitate to ask me. I'm going to try to find my broker information and put it down in the comments. But as always, you guys, could you please like, subscribe, and share to my channel? I appreciate it. I love the comments. I love the questions, because it just helps me to bring you on information, an informative episode, something that can help other people that are making the transition from whatever country to the Dominican Republic. So they're playing golf behind me. I'm just fingers crossed that this is a good golf player and the ball's not going to come hit me in the head, right? Okay. So guys, thank you as always for watching Ebony Ladies in the DR right here on YouTube every Thursday, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So y'all see what I'm doing, man. I'm enjoying the garden. I'm going to turn my chase lounge around and watch the golfers, and I'm just gonna enjoy this day. And if you have any more questions, don't hesitate. Talk to you soon.
Anytime she come around, something is about to go down. Listen to the siren sound. Wake up right now.